देर आर थ्री इम्पॉर्टेंट थ्योरम. द फर्स्ट इज कॉशी गुरसाट थ्योरम, सेकेंड इज कॉशी इंटीग्रल थ्योरम, थर्ड इज कॉशी रेसिड्यू थ्योरम. टू सॉल्व एनी इंटीग्रल ऑफ द कॉम्प्लेक्स एनालिसिस यू आर गोइंग टू यूज ओनली थ्री ऑफ थ्री थ्योरम इज इनफ. करेक्ट. सो लेट अस सी सम एग्जाम्पल. Suppose you are given a function like okay and some contour is given. Do you observe the when do we say this whether this inside function whether it is analytic function or not? If it is not analytic, and what do you think at which point this function is not analytic? Yes, this is quotient of two polynomial, correct? So polynomials are analytic function. Analytic in particular, you can think like you can differentiate at infinite number of times. It is n times differentiable, something like that. And particularly if I say then a function is said to be analytic function if we can write it in the power series expansion. See, look at the terms of power series. It contains first derivative, second derivative, third derivative. So that is the same thing jo maine pehle bola. Analytic means it should be differentiable infinitely many times. And our apna pehle ka definition dekho to kya hai. A function is said to be analytic at point if in that neighborhood it must be differentiable. And next CR equation satisfy wo sab wo sab hai, theek hai. Harmonic hone chahiye u and v, theek hai. What do you say about this function? At which point this is not analytic? Correct. So z equal to phi is singularity. Correct. And actually it is a pole of order 1. Do you know why? Because if any function I can write it of this form phi of z upon z minus e raised to n, then we say that a is a pole of order n. Correct. So this is actually a pole of order 1. Now everything is dependent on your contour. Okay. If you are having a contour where phi is not lying inside that, then the integral will be 0 by Cauchy-Gourisard theorem. What is Cauchy-Gourisard theorem saying? F of z is analytic throughout the domain and on C, throughout and on C, then what do you say? Integral f of z equal to 0. That is Cauchy-Gourisard theorem. So if I am giving you my contour, say C is this one, mod z equal to 2. So what is mod z equal to 2? It is circle with center 0 and radius 2, so it will be something like this. This is 0.2, correct. But what is my singularity? It is z equal to phi, which is lying outside my contour here somewhere, z equal to phi. So this is my singularity. So by Cauchy-Gourisard theorem, answer to this question will be it will be 0. Agreed? You agree? You just have to see the contour. In our case, I am giving you the contour mod z equal to 2. If my contour is something else, if I am taking contour is mod z equal to 6, suppose, then my singularity lie in the contour, correct? Z minus phi, no? So z equal to phi lie inside the contour z equal to 6, mod z equal to 6. So how will you solve this question? Do you remember Cauchy integral formula? Anyone? Yes. Anybody? What is Cauchy integral formula? What is right hand side? And same extended Cauchy integral formula. What is this thing? Hey, you don't remember this thing. What are you doing? You should remember this chance. Yes, 2 pi I f of e. Very nice. What about this one? Yes, 2 pi I f nth derivative at e upon n factorial, correct? Yes, yeah, good. So which formula should I use here? Here z minus phi raised to 1 hai, to apna first wala formula. So what will be the answer? It will be 2 pi I f of phi, that is phi square plus phi plus 1. So that is 31, na? 31 2's are 62. 62 pi I, that is the final answer, correct? Do you agree? Yeah, let us see one more problem. Suppose I am giving e raised to z sine z upon z minus 1 into z minus 2, or yeah, that is okay, z minus 1. Or let us just little bit change it. Z into z minus say pi by 2. Suppose these are the, this is the question. How will you solve this question? Think about it and tell me. Is it of that form, Cauchy integral formula? Remember one thing, in Cauchy integral formula, we can deal with one singularity at a time, because the formula suggests that in the denominator it will be there only, there is only one singularity, z equal to e, that is the only one singularity, and then only we can apply this formula. But if we are having two or three singularity, then what to do? Either you can do one thing, that is either you can break this function and you can write it as integral this upon z something into this upon this plus integral something upon z minus pi by 2, but that is not quite easy in all the case. It depends on the numbers, what number you are having, correct? So that is not easy. That is actually that is easy, but that is quite lengthy to do. You'll do it by partial fraction, multiply and get the value of e and so on. There is so much of lengthy process. I hope you understand the technique. Why I cannot use Cauchy integral formula directly here? Because there are two singularities. Do you see there are two poles? Z equal to 0 is a pole and z equal to pi by 2 is also pole. Correct? So if you go on doing your Cauchy integral formula, first you have to make this of this form. That is, you have to break the singularities and take each singularity together. That is, z equal to 0 here and z equal to pi by 2 here. Then I can apply. If somehow I can do that, then I can quickly apply this. I can quickly apply Cauchy integral formula here and I can quickly apply Cauchy integral formula here. Say p of x, p of z, q of z. Then answer will be 2 pi I p of z naught and 2 pi I actually 2 p of 0 actually, and here also 2 pi I, it will be q of pi by 2. That's it, correct? But look at this, in this question this is not given. So what do you know? Do you have anything else? I told you to solve an integral we are having only three things. Abhi first thing to hai nahi isme. I cannot apply Cauchy-Gourzade theorem. What is Cauchy-Gourzade theorem? In my contour there should not be any pole. There should not be any singularity. So but there are two singularities. So I cannot use Cauchy-Gourzade theorem. The second thing, can I use Cauchy integral formula? But I can use Cauchy integral formula only if I am having in the denominator only one singularity. Correct? So here I saw that there are two things. So I cannot use that also. What is the third thing I can do? What is the third thing remaining now? That is Cauchy residue theorem. What is Cauchy residue theorem is saying? Anybody, do you remember the statement? Let f of z has z1, z2, zn singularities or pole. Then integral f of z dz will be what? Do you remember Cauchy residue theorem? Two pi I sum of residue. I is running from 1 to n. This is the formula, correct? And one more thing, you know that to calculate residue, it is easy to write your function in this form. Suppose you want to calculate residue at suppose your function is of this form. Correct, that means this is z equal to a is a singularity, or you can say it is a pole here with, what is the order of that? Order is n plus 1, correct? Whenever you can write like this, then residue of the function, residue of f of z at z equal to a, it is what? Yes, phi nth derivative at a upon n factorial, that's it. If you put n equal to 0 here, then it will be just phi of a naught upon phi of a, just phi of a. So can I use it here now? Let us go back to our problem. E raised to z sine z. So answer to this question would be 2 pi I into residue at z equal to 0 of function plus residue at z equal to pi by 2 of function, where my f of z is this one. Now let us see, for z equal to 0, can I write my function of this form? F of z equal to e raised to z sine z upon z minus pi by 2 the whole upon the whole upon z. Can I write like this? You just need to make sure that this guy is analytic at z equal to 0. whether this numerator part is analytic at z equal to 0. To check analyticity, you just need to make sure that whether it is not defined somewhere. It is just a quotient of two things, where one thing is exponential or trigonometric or multiplication, and another thing is polynomial. So both are analytic function. So yes, it is analytic. So what will be residue? Residue of f of z at z equal to 0. It will be yes. What will be, what is the answer? Z equal to 0. So it will be just phi of 0. So what is phi of 0? E raised to 0 sine 0 upon, so answer is 0. So residue of f of z at z equal to 0 is 0. ये फर्स्ट मिल गया अपने को, करेक्ट. हाउ विल यू डू द नेक्स्ट वन? Can I write my function of this form? You just need to make sure that whether this guy is analytic at z equal to pi by 2. Yes. So what is the answer? What is the residue of function at z equal to pi by 2? It will be just substitute that to pi by 2. So it will be e raised to pi by 2 sine pi by 2. So that is e raised to pi by 2. Correct? Do you agree? So your final answer will be e raised to pi by 2. So do you see that given any integral का कोई भी question दिया है, you can always handle that, correct? Yeah. Let us solve one more problem. Try to solve this problem and tell me over some contour. Where the contour is, all the roots are lying inside that. Or you can just say mod z equal to say 2. Try to solve this problem. I'll give you 2 minutes and tell me the answer. How will you start, anyone? What do you see first? What are the singularities here? Tell me the singularity. Correct, 0 and plus minus I. whether they are lying in my contour. Yes, so how will you start, how will you solve this? You got three poles, do you see? 0, I and minus I. There are three poles. If there was only one pole or only one singularity, then I can handle it by Cauchy integral formula. But now I cannot apply Cauchy integral formula because there are three things in the same contour. So it is better to use Cauchy residue theorem. So what will you do? You just have to calculate residue at all the three points. That is, find residue at z equal to 0, find residue at z equal to I, and find residue at z equal to minus I. Then final answer will be 2 pi I into sum of all the residues. That's it. Do you see? Just try to find the residue at z equal to 0 and I and minus I and tell me the answer. Your function is this. Tell me once you get the answer. Yeah, anyone, what is the answer for the first one? Yes. One. Okay, how did you do that? First thing, what you have to do, you have to write your function in this form, that is sine hyperbolic of z upon z square plus 1 divided by z. Why? Because z equal to 0 pi in particular we are talking. So answer will be, so that is, this guy is your phi of z, you can say phi of z upon z. So the answer will be just phi of z naught, correct? Phi of 0 actually. Z naught is 0 in our case. So phi of 0 kya aayega, dekho. That is sine hyperbolic of 0 upon 0 plus 1. What is sine hyperbolic of 0? Do you remember hyperbolic ka definition kya tha? I hope you remember what is hyperbolic. What is cos hyperbolic? Tan hyperbolic will be this upon this. So sine hyperbolic 0 kya aayega? E raised to 0 minus e raised to 0 again. So that is 0 na? So residue will be 0 here, correct? Now can you tell me for this? Try to see the residue at this. What you How will you write this thing? Yes, how will you write? Okay. Very nice. Correct. Z minus I. Next thing, residue will be at Z equal to I, na? And this is at minus I. So Z equal to I answer will be, so this is your phi of Z, correct? Phi of Z upon Z minus I. So answer will be phi of I. It is better to write phi 1 phi 2 to not to get confused. Correct. What will be phi 2 of phi? It will be sine hyperbolic of I upon I into I plus I. What is sine hyperbolic of I? That is e raised to I minus e raised to minus I upon 2 to the 4 I square is minus 1, na? So it will be minus 4, minus upar bheja to, this will be minus, this will be plus, aisa. That is the final answer, this is. Similarly, the third one, you have to write the function sine hyperbolic of z upon z into z plus, z minus I, na? Z minus I upon z plus I. You just have to substitute, so this is your phi 3, you can take this thing as phi 3. Of z upon z plus I. So answer will be phi 3 of minus I. Is that clear? So to solve any integral like this, it is quite easy to solve. I hope it is easy for you also. Okay. So please do the practical